Congratulations on the new season. Where are you guys in taping right now? How far into it are you?
We're just ending the sixth episode and just about to start the seventh.
Now, when you first started the show, you're known to have a very active role. Everybody talks to you about this. I'm curious how, if you knew you were going to have an active role when you started up to the show, or was it something about the show halfway through where you just realized you loved it so much that you wanted to sort of take on this executive producer role that you've taken on?
No, the credit, the producer credit that I have on the show really is more sort of a retroactive credit, based on contribution and participation right from the very beginning, starting with the pilot. It just was how we have always made the show.
Are you the type of person who sort of can't help but contribute and participate in ways that a lot of actors don't normally do?
I suppose. I say what I think. I have a very strong desire that whatever I work on be the best that it possibly can be. I don't really work on anything that I work on unless I need to earn a living, because I have a very vital life outside of my work, and which I'm perfectly happy to indulge in that life all the time if I were able, but I have yet to come into great wealth. So I have always had to earn a living since I can remember. And so I guess this is a sort of diplomatic way of saying that everything I work on, I'm ultimately doing for the money. Because that's how I pay my bills. And I try and choose the best possible things that I can to work on. But I guess I probably just got in the habit of working as hard as I possibly can and investing as much as I possibly can on whatever I am working on so that I don't... It sort of mitigates some of the shame of the fact that I'm actually doing it for the money.
Possibly just heard a major story of your life and the reasons for living.
I don't know about that. I just know that the things I have worked since I was very, very young, not just as an actor, but you know,
you dropped out of high school to be an actor, right?
I dropped out of high school to be, you know, a gangster or like a private detective or a pirate or something.
But, one of the many characters you've played.
But those things didn't pan out, so... but in any case, I did a lot of things, lots of odd jobs and a lot of manual labor jobs and things. It turns out that the acting seemed to have more of a future, for me at least. So I continued with that. And I enjoy it. I love stories, and always have. And I think that's probably what kept me going in terms of that, is I love to read. I really love to read a great deal. And I like to write, just, you know, for myself. And I like to, you know, pretend. You know, when I was moved to New York and I was, you know, shoveling shit at the Claremont Writing Academy, working as a messenger, you know. I swept floors at the Minskoff rehearsal studios, and a whole bunch of different things. But, you know, when I'd be doing that, you know, I'd be walking along the streets and, you know, pretending I was tailing somebody, or, you know. You know, or just, you know, anyway.
Pretending.
Yeah, and I think that's probably why it is that what kept me going in terms of, you know, it started out just, you know, playing in the, making believe in the backyard, you know, and then it turned into a career.